Ken Keller, Marinette City Council, also one of the 28 that passed that resolution. What I wanted to say, and you just, that was my question, mitigation of hazardous materials. And there are no answers for that until it would actually be in production if something catastrophic does happen. It's kind of too late. But just so everybody is aware, the people we really should be grateful to are sitting in the front row right here.
No sulfide mine.
No sulfide mine. Thank you. So, and this is supposed to be a sulfide mine. So, we have to fight. You have to write your letter to the top. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Regina Sheltree. I'm a resident of Menominee, Michigan. My family's been here for at least 7 generations. They came in through Canada, and we've been owners on the Menominee River for over 70 years, just a little way, a mile or so down the river from the mine site. I brought some information about the water testing that was done in the levels from the DNR at the Flambeau mine. And I also called up on my phone the Rust County study that was done on the flatline economics of the Flambeau mine, but we couldn't get it to the system. So if anybody wanted to look up what happened at Flambeau as far as economics, it's Flambeau Exposed. You can just Google it. And otherwise, I'm going to put some slides up on our Save the Menominee River site so that you can see that actually more growth happened in Rust County after the mine was closed for a few years. Nothing good came to them from that mine. And I just wanted to tell you to look for that information. And I don't know if you wanted to see any of the graphs that were about the, this was the baseline water level of manganese before Flambeau opened. It was at 230 parts per million of manganese. Public health, 300. Fold projection, 350. Upon close, even though it wasn't processed on site, it still went totally through the roof. This is the sulfates. Here it was 5 parts per billion was the baseline study. 10 parts per billion is the standard that wild rice can live with. Drinking water is 350 parts per billion. The fold projection already was going to be almost triple that at 1100, but still they exceeded it greatly and continue to. And then this is the iron, 50 parts per billion, 300 for drinking water, 320 for fold. And as the years go by, it continues to grow. And then this is the same thing. But I wanted to give you guys copies of that. Thank you. So everyone, thank you. I'm so glad that you're here. I really thought that we'd have so many people that we'd have to move it into the gymnasium. So hopefully next time we'll all bring our friends and neighbors and there'll be be an even greater turnout, although every single person that's here, I thank you from the bottom of my heart and from my daughter. You know, I love the Menominee River. I've swam there all my life. I was a lifeguard at Sheehy Lakes in high school, and you know, it's a really special place to me, and it should be protected.
Hi, my name is Jeff Bush. I live in Eschewell, Wisconsin. I just have a few points of interest. I worked on the dams above and below the Menominee River. I was in Millrate for a lot of years. I worked on the turbines and the water generating plants. The dams on the Menominee River right now are so soft that you can take a 16-penny nail with a hammer and hit it into the concrete. They are ready to explode. If we ever have a 100-year flood, who knows what will happen on this end. And another thing we have to look at. We have protests every Friday night outside the Ogden Club, which is at Human Resources Headquarters. Do I see any of these faces to come and help us protest against these people? I don't see very few in this room. We need to get the tail off between our legs and start stepping on these people. We, the people, are the boss of these politicians. The politicians should listen to us. We are the boss of the politicians. What happens when an employee don't listen to their boss? They're fired. So we have to start stepping on every single individual to stop this mine from taking place, the devastation of our area. And I'm speaking with all my heart. I don't enjoy doing this, but I am here doing it. We need to see all faces and all neighbors on both sides of the river to come and stop this mine.
My name is Paula Bohan. I'm a political scientist. I live in Madison, Wisconsin, but my mother grew up in Menominee. My grandmother lived here her whole life, and I have relatives all through this area, all through Cedar River, Escanaba, all through the area. I grew up in this area, and I can tell you, first, I was trying to think if I should talk as a political scientist or if I should talk as someone who loves the water, and maybe I'll make a comment about both. First of all, I was going to bring my water bottle up here. I stopped and filled up my water bottle. I don't know if you realize how good your water is. I don't know if you realize how good your water tastes. Madison, it's clean. You won't get sick from it, but it doesn't taste as good. I'm going to fill, I brought a couple extra water bottles. I'll fill them up and take them back with me and you know, squander them as long as I can. Not let people know where I got the water from. As a political scientist, I pay attention to budgets. And the federal budget just got released yesterday. The EPA is facing some major cuts. At least they're talking at least 30, 31%. That'll go down a bit. But the enforcement from the federal government is going to be pulled back, and that's something we all just have to prepare for. We're talking about Green Bay. We're talking about the Lake Superior watershed. We're talking about resources that will be available for local people when there is a catastrophe, when there is a leak. The Michigan state budget has also just been released, and DEQ is facing a major cut. So right now we're looking at self-reporting from the company and periodic spot-checking by DEQ. If they lose fewer of their resources than they have now, we can't be sure that what you have here is going to be protected. The last thing I would say is that what you have in this area, the wealth, is the water and the sense of community. I've met several people coming up here on the tours and some of the other places, and you have some of the nicest people in the world in this area. So the community is what will save you, and your water is what sustains you, and which actually is the base of the Lake Superior watershed. So I'm on the Wisconsin side. We're all counting on you to help. Thank you very much.
For my first number, no, I'm just kidding. So my name is Laura Rowell. I serve on a lot of different committees throughout the community. One of them is the Waterfront Festival Committee. One of them is the Marinette Tourism Marketing Committee. And another is the Menominee Community Foundation Water. I don't even know what it's called, but it's about protecting water in the Great Lakes Basin. So there's a lot of committees in our community that care about the water, that obviously we're just about to be delisted, so there's that committee, I'm not on that one, but so many people care about protecting the water, and I just want to say that in case you're thinking that the only way our water is going to get polluted is from one of those breaches, it'll happen well before those breaches. as Dr. Gedicks said, it'll be leaching through the water, the groundwater all the time. So don't just think it's going to be a catastrophe. I also want to mention that too many times, cleanup from acid mine drainage is left to the taxpayers in the form of a Superfund site, which Dr. Gedick also said, and now you just said that EPA is being defunded. So the bill would be for the taxpayers to clean it up. And yes, in the permit, Aquila has permitted a mere $24.8 million for end-of-life construction of the mine and $105 million for their end-of-life of mine operating period. Okay, so that is not even close to enough, because our neighbors in Minnesota are doing the same fight we're doing against Polymet Mine, and they're figuring 50 years of treatment at $436 million. And so did you hear my first numbers for ours? That was only for 30 years. And then the Minnesota ones, they're already planning $436 million. Experts say that's not even close to enough. That's not even close to enough. So any of the money that they're already kind of setting aside for possible cleanup at the end of the mine isn't even next to near enough. So I just want you guys to realize that, and realize from the taxpayers' point of view that there's not enough money in any slush fund anywhere. And then also, if anyone's interested, you can get a tour of the sacred Menominee sites up by the 60 Islands area, up on the River Road. You can probably find more information on the no back40.com website.